Hi, I'm Jim Kakalios, physics professor at the University of Minnesota and one of the science consultants for the new Sony film, The Amazing Spider-Man. Thanks to the National Academy of Sciences Science and Entertainment Exchange Program, Hollywood calls on scientists like me to help them create a believable fake reality. Whether it's the quantum physics behind Watchmen's Dr. Manhattan, or Tony Stark's lab in Iron Man, Hollywood knows that any time the audience is questioning what they're seeing on screen is a moment when they're not paying attention to the story. At the University of Minnesota, I teach a class on superhero science, which led to my writing a popular science book, The Physics of Superheroes. For The Amazing Spider-Man, I consulted on the physics of wall crawling and the tensile strength of spiders' webbing. But I know what you really want to know about the movie. Is there any math? The filmmakers asked me to create an equation relating to cell regeneration and human mortality called the Decay Rate Algorithm. Naturally, I thought of the Gompertz equation. Have you ever wondered why no one lives to be 350 years old and few make it past 115? You might think that once you make it to, say, 25 years old, that you'd have a constant chance of dying in any given year. But just as some people can play the lottery repeatedly and not win, out of billions of people on the planet, there would be some who are very, very old. Why doesn't this happen? Think of it as the death lottery, which no one wants to win, but we all do eventually. Unlike a real lottery, the longer you live, the greater your chances of eventually winning. My colleague at the University of Minnesota, physics professor Boris Shklovsky. Hi, Boris.
Hi, Jim.
Figured out why this is so in a physics paper he published a few years ago. Imagine defective cells in your body as criminals and your immune cells as cops on the street. When you're young, it's as if there's a lot of cops on the beat, and it's very difficult for the defective cells to reproduce and form a lethal population. As we age, it is as if a series of budget cuts has reduced the number of patrolmen, and eventually, crime wins out. This, for me, is the beauty of science. Patterns await discovery in nature, in the laboratory, through telescopes, sometimes even in actuarial tables. Every atom in the periodic table has a unique fingerprint, pattern of wavelengths of light that they emit. Trying to understand where these patterns came from led to the development of quantum mechanics, which in turn led to the transistor and the laser, and eventually led to the technology we have today. Well, Kirk Connors would know the real Gompertz equation, and the filmmakers wanted the formula to be visually complex. So I took some expressions from the reliability theory of aging and longevity and some mathematical glitter and created the equation in the film. Behind Spider-Man is Peter Parker, and behind Peter Parker is some real and interesting science in the guise of the decay rate algorithm. We may not have spider powers or turn into giant lizards, but our ability to use our intelligence to understand the world around us is our real superpower. As a wise man once said, face front, true believer. ¶¶